सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। Today's subject is Anandagandha Chakra, source of superconscious healing. The truth about the Anandagandha, first you should know a few things about the Anandagandha, the facts, then you will understand the power of the science. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Raja Vidya Raja Guhyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam. It is the highest knowledge, that is why it is kept as a highest secret. Raja Vidya Raja Guhyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam. In Vedic tradition, all big philosophy, the technical terms like a Mahavagyas, the Aham Brahmasmi or Prajnanam Brahma, are the great mantras like Namah Shivaya, Namo Narayana. All the great technical terms are used at least 100 times in different literatures, even though it is supposed to be the highest secret. But you should understand this important thing, you see. Even the Bija mantras, the seed mantras like a Rajeshwari seed mantras, the Shodasi, Panjadasi, even those kind of highest secret mantras were used in many places in the form of writing. But you will be shocked and surprised. This great science, Raja Vidya, Anandagandha, this word is used throughout Sanskrit literature only in one place in Shankara, in Vishwanatha Ashtakam. I can say no Sanskrit word can claim, forget about spiritual truth, no Sanskrit word in the whole Sanskrit language is used only in one place, only in one by one master in the whole spiritual literature. This word Anandagandha is used only by Shankara, only in one place, Vishwanatha Ashtakam. That is why it is called Raja Vidya Raja Guhyam. King of the knowledge, the most guarded secret. This science was the highest guarded secret. That is why, even by mistake, nobody is using this word. See, everybody knows this word is a popular word. It's one of the popular word means, I can say, the most kept secret popular word. Even the Mahavagya, Sannyasa mantras are penned down in many places, spoken about in many places. But this one word, almost everybody protected it like a religion. Nobody. Only Shankara. When he was singing about Vishwanatha, the ecstasy is too much, so he just spelled it out. What he received from Vishwanatha, so he spelled it out. Throughout the Sanskrit literature, if you analyze, of course, world's largest spiritual literature bank, the Sanskrit literature, you can't say there is second word which is used only once in the whole literature. This is the only word. Google the word Anandagandha, the only reference you will get is our Dhyanapitam message. Nowhere you will get any reference. Nobody has used. Nobody, you see, if they know, they did not reveal it to public. If they are able to reveal it to public market, they didn't know. The science maintained, not even in the hands of enlightened beings, in the hands of only incarnations. It comes from eternal silence. Anandaganda. The science delivered to planet Earth only when incarnations land in planet Earth. I can say this is the ID card of incarnations. Social security number. Driving license, maybe I can say flying license. That is why the truth, the secret knowledge about Anandaganda, first time becomes available to the mass, because it is only now the necessity to reach the mass and possibility to reach the mass for enlightened beings have happened. One, the necessity to reach the mass has happened only now because there is no one geography dedicated to the enlightenment science. Till my last predecessor, there was always one geography dedicated to this great truths. They don't need to reach to the mass. If they create one group and create that, transmit that science, it's done and they take care. But unfortunately, after the India's independence, worst calamity happened to the planet Earth is the geography dedicated to enlightenment is destroyed. It lost its uniqueness in the name of pseudo-secularism. Understand, real secularism is taking the essence of all religions and using it, experiencing it. But the pseudo-secularism, discarding all great truths of all religions and living your own materialistic culture. Anyhow, so the planet Earth is now swindled. So now the necessity to reach the mass has happened. Second thing, the possibility to reach the mass has also happened. I want all of you to know, do not ever think only a few hundred of you are listening to my message every day. 12,000 people are waiting continuously every day just to hear what Swamiji is uttering today. Understand? This is the lowest number I am telling you. If you look in the other angle, I can say millions. To speak from the factor of safety, million. See, to speak from the safety factor, I am talking 12,000. But if I have to say from the other side, it's millions waiting around the world. When I say 12,000, I can say 12,000 PCs. Many times, each PC or connection is watched by many people. Anyhow, apart from that, there are people who don't come regularly every day, but who visit our YouTube in different ways. The number I spoke is only through our YouTube channel. There are so many channels nowadays have started using our videos independently. I'm talking about 7,000 hours. 7,000 hour videos are being used by people independently in their channels. The other day I was googling one huge religious channel run by Christian missionaries, Christian channel, having a high viewership and posted our video in a very positive way, my experience with Krishna, the happening, that video, and amazing views, number of views, and great comments below the video. I was shocked. Then I understood, there are many Christian missionaries who are seeking the spiritual truth of Christian theology. Many fathers and nuns, intense seekers. Not only this missionary video channel, hundreds of video channels are using our videos independently. So understand, the need to reach mass and ability to reach mass has happened first time in an incarnation's life. After these two happened, maybe I'm the first guy happening. So, that is why I have to set all new trends. All pathfinders are path breakers. That is the reason the science of Anandaganda is revealed to the world first time. That's a source of superconscious healing. Understand? You have seven major energy centers. About the seven major energy centers, almost all religions talk. The eighth energy center, where all these seven merge, become one with, is what is Anandaganda. That is why I say, it is not even a separate chakra, it is a space, source of superconscious energy, where the matter comes in direct contact with consciousness, where the consciousness is directly touching the matter. It is the experience where the consciousness has samyoga into matter, where matter has samyoga with consciousness. When you relax into that space, consciousness fills matter. So naturally, the superconscious healing happens. It is the highest happening which can happen to matter, not just physical healing or mental healing, radiating pure consciousness. Understand? My advent has happened to give a breakthrough for human consciousness, to bring new consciousness, new age man. New man who does not age. New consciousness. Two people in the world suffer forever. One, the people who suffer seeing the joy and bliss of the master, because he is going to be always blissful. You are never going to be out of suffering. The second, people who can't tolerate the joy of the disciples who stay with the master, because they are also going to be joyful forever. These two people, people who can't tolerate the joy of the master, the declarations, claims, words, prophecies of the master, And the people who can't tolerate the joy and ecstasy of the disciples who stay with Master. These two can never have joy. They have to suffer, 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 suffer and disappear into suffering. No other way. So if you are in these two group, save yourself if you can. The source of Ananda Ganda which is source of spiritual superconscious healing is the ultimate science towards enlightenment, not just physical healing or mental healing. Physical healing also happens because your very DNA structure gets re-altered when you relax into superconscious state. The other day I was reading a book, The Biology of Belief. A great scientist who has done a great service to spiritual tradition. His research has really proved even the very DNA structure can be changed if your consciousness infiltrates the matter. Anandaganda chakra is the door where consciousness can infiltrate matter, where it can fill you. Where it can give you the extraordinary conscious experience, means breakthrough in human consciousness. I tell you, even the definition of enlightenment, I am updating and upgrading. Understand, I am not only updating the definition of enlightenment, I am upgrading the experience of enlightenment to human bodies. The possibility, the highest possibility which can be experienced in human body, even that highest possibility is being raised. That is why I am saying, I am upgrading the highest conscious happening on the human body. I am breaking the very consciousness on which they are standing. I am giving a breakthrough to the whole human consciousness. I am inviting all the people who feel the sacredness of my work, my contribution to the human society, to drop small differences, to drop all these petty ideas, one or two if you carry, and gather together to spread this science to the world and protect it without being extincted, destroyed by these unconscious groups, establishments. I am giving open invitation. Whoever feels helped by what I am doing, sympathetic towards what I am doing, feeling friendly for what I am doing, feels this ought to be done to save planet Earth, I invite all of you to drop these petty, foolish, small ideas, self-centered sufferings. If you are self-centered constantly, you will create suffering for you. Drop all those foolish things. Let's stand together to preserve, protect and spread this great science of Anandaganda, the great process of giving breakthrough, great breakthrough, transformation to human consciousness. The very science itself cannot be described in one session. I'll try to give you the glimpse. The higher you move in your chakras, the more subtle you become. The subtlest possible chakra is Anandaganda chakra, where you are no more ordinary human and just disappeared into the extraordinary super consciousness. The technique or the process is two. One, if it has to be done just by your effort, unclutching. If it can be done with my effort also, process. If it has to be done only by me, initiation. Two method. One, technique, unclutching. Second, process. These are the two methods. And the third is beyond. 100% when master takes the responsibility, it's initiation. When you take more responsibility, it is meditation, technique, untouching. That is a technique. If I take more responsibility, then it is called process. So many processes which we are doing, like a living enlightenment process. If I take 100% responsibility, it is called initiation. Because it is such a powerful science, when people are empowered with it, they become really, really powerful. The science was stored as Raja Vidya and Raja Guhya, highest knowledge and highest secret. For the unqualified people, when it is given, it can create a lot of nuisance. The tradition says, if this truth is told to the unqualified person, the person who is telling, his head will burst. I thought it's too much of frightening idea. It is told just to keep the mouth of the master shut and to share only with the right people. But I tell you, really, if you give it to the people who are not qualified, your head does not burst, but at least they try to break your head. I tell you from my experience. But anyhow, still we have our own safety mechanism. Still cosmos saves. Still is on job. Life God on duty. Unclutching continuously, bringing more and more awareness to all the movements happening in your system, can be used as a technique to reach Anandaganda. And the more needs to be experienced through the proper processes. And already I have revealed those proper processes to the whole world through so many programs. I only invite the whole world to come and experience those programs and experience Anandaganda Chakra and ultimately experience the superconscious healing. Let you all experience and radiate enlightenment. Experience and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.